Hi, I'm John Cranton. Let's talk NFL action on Sunday. Great battle in the AFC as the Patriots head to Pittsburgh to take on the Steelers, two of the top teams in the conference. In fact, over the last 10 years, these teams have won 5 Super Bowls and have been to 2 others. Two of the top teams again meeting here. Patriots come off a bye week. They are 5-1, straight up 4-2 against the spread. This offense, number 1 in the NFL with over 400 yards per game. They're also 4th in points with 30.8 points per game. And they're tops in passing with 350.5 yards passing per game. Great passing attack led by quarterback Tom Brady. A little heavy on the interceptions this year, but still 16 touchdowns, 8 picks. He's got outstanding targets. Newcomer Ocho Cinco really hasn't got going, but he hasn't been that bad. But they still have wide receiver Wes Welker, Deion Branch, and a dynamite pair of second-year tight ends, Rob Gronkowski. He's the tall target that Brady uses in the red zone. And Aaron Hernandez has outstanding speed. They love to get him on linebackers and create mismatches. And this offense has been cooking all season long. Problem for the Patriots, though, the defense has been terrible. Like last year, they are last in the NFL in yards, giving up just over 423 yards per game. Pass defense is very young secondary. They are dead last in yards, giving up a whopping 322 yards passing per game. Their top linebacker, Gerard Mayo, he is still out for another couple weeks with a knee problem. That's why the Patriots are on a 19-7 run over the total. Now the Steelers come in. They are first in pass defense with giving up just 172 yards per game in the air. So you got the great pass offense against the great pass defense. And they're perfect at home, 3-0 straight up, 2-1 against the spread. And since that opening game loss to Baltimore, they've been playing great ball, 5-1 straight up, 4-2 against the spread. Now, this offense is 9th in the NFL in passing with 265 yards per game. Actually have very good balance, 15th in rushing, but they've been better of late. And a pretty good running game considering their offensive line has had problems all season with injuries. In fact, in their 7 games, they've used a different offensive line combination in all 7 games. Big Ben Roethlisberger has outstanding targets in Mike Wallace, tight end Heath Miller, Hines Ward, and Antonio Brown. He's the guy who shined in that last game when they destroyed Arizona 32-20. Brown had a career-high 102 yards receiving. All these receivers for Pittsburgh should do very well against this soft New England secondary. Steelers are home from that long road trip at Arizona, but the defense is number 2 in total yards and points allowed, 17.4 points per game. Problem with them is turnovers. They have a minus 10 turnover margin along with this weak offensive line, but the Patriots don't have a very good pass rush. Last year's meeting final score was 39-26. A little odd, though, was only 10-3 at the half, but the offenses ended up with over 420 total yards each, and both passing attacks were unstoppable with over 345 yards each. That's the way I'm looking at this game. Pittsburgh as a home dog is very inviting, 6-1 against the spread, but the Patriots on the road, 46-22 ATS, so I'm looking for a high-scoring game in this one. Now, if you look at morning plays all weekend long, including Sunday, Jim Feist has sides and totals in the colleges and the pros all available right here on this website. Enjoy the games, and we'll see you next week.